There are situations in life where you cannot back out. Those are the situations to fight. The story of such a battle where situation was not to back out but to fight was Battle of Bunker Hill. Here goes the story. The Battle of Bunker Hill took place on June 17, 1775, just a few months after the start of the American Revolutionary War. Boston was being besieged by thousands of American militia. The British were trying to keep control of the city and control its valuable seaports. There were two hills that the British wanted to take in order to be able to bombard the Americans from a distance. These were Breed's Hill and Bunker Hill. The Battle of Bunker Hill actually took place mostly on Breed's Hill. It's only called the Battle of Bunker Hill because the British Army thought they were on Bunker Hill. The British were led up the hill by General William Howe. The Americans were led by Colonel William Prescott. Americans secretly moved their troops onto Bunker and Breed's Hill, two unoccupied hills just outside of Boston in Charlestown, Massachusetts. The American troops worked hard during the night building up the defenses. Much of the wall they built, called a redoubt, was nearly 6 feet high. They built up fortifications during the night and prepared for battle. The next day, when the British realized what had happened, the British attacked. Their commander William Howe led three charges up Breed's Hill. The Americans fought back the first two charges, but started to run out of ammunition. Colonel William Prescott always knew how not to waste ammunition and said to the soldiers, "Don't fire until you see the whites of their eyes." Meaning do not shoot till you see the British in front of your eyes. The soldiers followed the order and used ammunition only when a British was seen. Americans might have retreated at their third charge and the British gained the hill, but their costs were great. Around 226 British were killed and 800 wounded, while the Americans did not suffer nearly as many casualties. The lessons we learn from this story are: 1. When you are low in ammunition, decide to hold on the fire till the right time to fire. 2. Wait for the right opportunity, do not use all your talents, or ammunitions, at one place where it might not be required at all. 3. Time is an illusion. Timing is an art. Timing is everything. 4. Waiting for the correct time is not an action, but an action waiting for the right action at the right time. 5. It's always about timing. If it's too soon, no one understands. If it's too late, everyone's forgotten. I will come back with more stories that will change your life. Have a nice day ahead. Stay tuned.